people have is that this is about religion, tradition, regions, right? So they're like, oh, culture, Indian culture, or if they're a little bit more nuanced, they may say that, oh, regional cultures, that's where it caps off. So people imagine that culture is big things, you know, language, traditions, festivals. And they would, if they were savvy, they would pay attention at the point of perhaps packaging things like that, where they'd say, you know, this color means this, right? That's what culture is about. Unfortunately, that's where the understanding of culture drops off, even in our marketing courses. Like the most they'll tell you is that, oh, in some country, this word could mean something else, or in India, red means something, but somewhere else it means. That's very big things. Actually, as an anthropologist, my job is to tell people and make them realize how culture is everything. You know, how fish cannot see water because it's literally around you, and everything you've experienced is because of culture, which is why you don't realize it. And a way to explain it is culture is simply people's way of life, right? And we think about it in this way of our traditions, festivals, religion, because in the past it was very fixed. Cultural change was not something that happened on a daily basis or weekly, yearly basis, because you would need two things. Either you need a technological invasion, or you need invention, or you need an actual physical invader who brings in a new culture. So culture was always seen as a very static thing, right? This is the culture of this place. This is the culture of this community. But now, since you've had your industrial revolution, you've had post-World War, and you have technology enter mainstream, every day people have options of what to do with a certain technology. And I'm calling everything technology, from your information to your gadgets and all of that. What they actually do with that is what culture is. Everybody is making different uses of the same things. So 150 years ago, you could have said the culture of a certain place. Now you can't say it because there'll be so many subcultures, there'll be so many smaller nuances that you can't definitively say, oh, this is the culture. Now you'll have to go smaller. Now you'll have to say, okay, the culture in Bangalore among techies who work for certain kinds of companies. So when nuance comes in, that's where culture has a role to play. There's this third definition of culture, which is not at all known by people, but is really actually what we study often in anthropology, in organizational anthropology, which is really the culture inside businesses and the culture of business. And this is a bit complicated because what it really says is that whatever kind of line of work you're in, or whatever industry you work in, has its own culture that you don't realize. Now, I could give you an example, right? When you're in advertising, there is a certain culture, there are certain standards of living, there are certain references you are supposed to understand, there are certain hierarchies you are supposed to know. And that is exactly what culture is, right? The unsaid, the framework, but we don't really accept it as such. So, one of the things, the reason I named many of my speeches as culture in the room is because the elephant in the room is because this is what we don't talk about. It's there, and we don't, you know, realize it's there. My last point about
Sure.
culture is something that often is, I think it's such a broad thing that becomes very difficult to explain to people, but the way in which business is done anywhere in the world, right? The way in which business and marketing, even advertising to a certain extent, is taught has a huge cultural problem, because it's taught from the perspective of where products were manufactured and advertised, and your consumer was just going to fall for it, you know, because there was no competition, there was no availability of products. You're talking about a time where commodity was really selling and advertising was giving you the push. Right now, very few people are buying product. They're buying into brand, they're buying into purpose, they're buying into what they feel about a certain company. And this may seem like, oh, it's very exaggerated, but it's not, right? It's actually pretty much mainstream and here to stay, which is kind of what culture is about. What do people actually feel, think about a certain brand? It's not what we think about the people. So in that sense, culture tells you that your consumer is actually a stakeholder in your business. Like, they need to be 50% part of the conversation. They're not passively receiving what you're making. They are actively creating, they are co-creating, they are reusing, remixing. And the lag between what you produce and how people feel about it has gone away, because earlier maybe people would wait for a newspaper article or a book to say that this product is good, bad, etc. Now it's in real time, which means that they have the power, which means they